working as a scientist in the biomedical, biotech field. It's very engaging, it's exhilarating. The standards are very high, the expectations are high, but it's so deeply collaborative and there is a collective goal that you're aiming towards. When you bring that all together, you can really make an impact in the world. I work in the field of antibody discovery, and the ultimate goal is to find antibodies that can be developed into a therapeutic drug. And we want to be able to do that in the fastest, most efficient way possible and find the rarest and the best antibodies. We really do look for the needles in the haystack. When COVID hit, our company was already a part of a group that was working specifically towards pandemic prevention. We were able to access one of the first samples from a US patient that had recovered from COVID-19. And we dived right into that to try to find antibodies that could be used as a drug against COVID. This was a sprint, and we knew exactly what was at stake. The sense of responsibility, the sense of pressure was all very real, and it was literally around the clock. We found an antibody from that sample to a human trial within 90 days, and that was unprecedented. Personally, I feel very humbled by the small part that I was able to play, and at the same time, really awed by what is possible when people pull together. And it just leaves me with this question of what else can we do? I was born in Lahore, the city of gardens and the historic cultural center of Pakistan. I moved to Saudi Arabia just before my second birthday, and that was home for me. It was a very diverse upbringing. We had multicultural perspectives and friends from all over the world. Because I was just an insatiable learner, I knew I wanted to be some kind of an ist. I, you know, went from marine biologist to paleontologist to astrophysicist, and there was always some kind of science-related career choice that I envisioned for myself. I applied to universities across the world, multiple different countries, including Pakistan, and ultimately I ended up choosing McGill University. Coming to Canada was really exciting. It was a new phase of my life. I still have leaves saved from my first autumn. My first week at college was 9/11. That definitely changed things. At the time, I also did hijab, and so I was a very visible Muslim. You feel vulnerable and you feel exposed. I was not the target of any kind of real violence, but I had friends and family that were, and it was a very difficult time. We've come some ways since then, but there is still a lot of work to be done in that area. Growing up Muslim, it was an identity that instilled a sense of pride. As I've grown over the years, my faith has become deeply spiritual in thought and a grounding for me in real life. Working in a company like AbCellera, there's no such thing as a typical day. I have spent back-to-back weeks in the lab carrying out experiments, and then there have been times where I have been glued to my desk. I'm very adaptable, and that has been enormously helpful, coupled with my technical training and my educational background in really meeting the demands of my position. I always thought that as a woman in tech, I was going to be entering into a male-dominated field, but actually, I work with a team of 38 women and 3 men. And we have people across the company that are from all over the world that have completely different backgrounds, so it's been really interesting to work in this kind of an environment and seeing how connected and supportive and engaged you can be with a different dynamic. There are moments when somebody just has a spark and they just say it, and everybody just has this eureka moment. And the high that you get at that time is just something that you cannot replicate in any other situation. These are problems that impact everyday life, and you are there at the forefront of that, trying to make a positive difference. And it's incredible.